Shalom lechem, shalom. I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat. We're living in exciting times. We're in the 70th year of the nation of Israel. We know that's prophetic. We're in the year where the U.S. Embassy has been moved from Tel Aviv to Yerushalayim to Jerusalem, recognizing Jerusalem as the eternal biblical capital. We understand that there's never been a generation closer to the second coming of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus, than this generation. We're not setting any dates, but we know that the time is near. Jews and Arabs are being saved like never before. And everything that we see that's happening in the world, all these attacks against Israel, is Revelation chapter 12, verse 17. And the dragon was enraged. The dragon, Satan, knows that his days are numbered. He knows that the key is Israel, and therefore he's enraged. But you can't stop the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus. The gospel will go forth. The gospel will go back to Jerusalem. We will meet the Lord in the air and go home. Hallelujah. Praise his name. Psalms 118, verse 26. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus, rides into Jerusalem on a donkey. And he's entering the eastern gate. We know prophetically what that points to. The eastern gate points towards the Mount of Olives. And the Bible says that Yeshua HaMashiach ascended from the Mount of Olives, and his feet will land back on the Mount of Olives. We understand this as believers in Yeshua, in Jesus. And as he's riding on a donkey into the eastern gate, the time frame is Nisan 10. Nisan 10 is 4 days before Passover, which falls on Nisan 14. And in Nisan 10, what happens is, from the northern side of the gate, pointing to Bethlehem, house of bread, where Yeshua was born, the high priests are bringing in the sheep in order to inspect them for the Passover. And they're singing Psalms 118. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. And on the eastern gate, as Yeshua, Jesus, is riding into Jerusalem on a donkey, the disciples and the believers are hailing him, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna. And the Pharisees get upset and they tell Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus. We read this encounter in the book of Luke, chapter 19, verses 38 to 40. Blessed is the king who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest. And some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to Yeshua, to Jesus, Teacher, rebuke your disciples. And Yeshua replies to them, Even if I keep quiet, the very rocks will cry out my name. And Yeshua HaMashiach was speaking about 1 Kings chapter 11, verse 26. I will give one tribe to his son, so that David my servant may always have a lamp before me in Yerushalayim, in Jerusalem, the city where I chose to put my name. Yeshua HaMashiach was speaking literal, and he was also speaking spiritual, because the new Jerusalem is Yeshua HaMashiach. Even if I do keep quiet, the very rocks will cry out my name. The 70th year of the nation of Israel, the time where the president of America, Donald Trump, does the impossible, recognizes what no president since 1995 was willing to do, he did. Recognizes Jerusalem as the eternal, biblical capital. Thus says the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. We're not saying that Donald Trump is an angel. We're not even saying that he's a pastor. What we are saying is he's being used by the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob for such a time like this. Even if the UN tries to stop Israel, the very rocks will cry out my name. Yeshua HaMashiach's name is on Jerusalem. Let's continue to rejoice together as souls are being saved in Israel, as the gospel is being preached. Achekol Israeli Vasha, until all Israel shall be saved. Romans 11:26. Until next time, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, sending you blessings from Yerushalayim, from Jerusalem, in the mighty name of Jesus Yeshua. Shalom.